See, my hook for getting into Dana's voice was always, alright.
Alright.
Oh, no. Quite good.
Alright.
You do it with the head tilt.
Alright.
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 Yeah. It's just taking me an entire series to try and get
Dana.
That.
Dana.
Dana.
Dana. Dana. Okay.
Hi, I'm Gina. I'm here with Emma Corrin and Josh O'Connor from The Crown, and these are their Netflix Nine. So obviously you two are now fictional counterparts of one of the most famous couples in history. What was it like, though, the first time you actually met in real life?
First time we actually met in real life, Emma was reading in for Diana while we were casting Camilla. And she was just in, she was brought in to read in for Diana just for the day. And everyone on The Crown fell in love with her. That's the first time?
That's probably the first time. Yeah.
What did you think of me? Because I just said all those
things. Can't remember. I just remember you being like, bumbling around.
There you go. That's about as good as you're going to get.
Everyone fell in love with you and you were bumbling around.
Bumbling around, buzzing around.
Buzzing around.
It's actually pretty good, yeah. Pretty accurate.
Is there a level of pressure that comes with all of the anticipation around this particular story, and are you shitting yourself, basically, about it coming out?
Yeah, currently. there is such a high level of pressure that comes with these roles. You kind of have to remind yourself that this is fictional. Mm. The Crown is fictional, and you know, it's Peter Morgan's storytelling. We are storytellers, and these are characters. Just as much as they also see real people. Mm-hmm. And for me, I think that was a really important distinction in the whole process of doing research and getting to grips with Diana, was that, you know, the research was really helpful, very informative, but actually when I got the scripts and when I started working with Polly Bennett, who helped with movement, and, you know, doing more work on, like, physicality and psychology, I suppose that was, yeah, it kind of helped leave all the hot air and the voices and the, like, ah.
Let's talk about the royal accent. It's arguably the poshest accent on earth. Basically, I was just going to ask how long it took you both to get that accent down, because it's...
Mine's not. I don't have a royal accent. Mine's
Yeah, that's so different.
But she does have a very distinctive voice, but go.
It's very different. Charles is very different. They're all quite different.
Yeah.
So, like, the Queen's is sort of mad. I mean, it's totally unique. Phillips and Charles. Phillips comes from a sort of German influenced sort of accent as well. Mm. And then Charles is like an amalgamation.
I've tried to recreate it. I'm from South London. It's just not happening. Like, I can't do it.
I bet you could. No. Can I teach you something?
You don't move your mouth when you talk.
You're going to get it right now, I think.
Okay, right.
So what you need to do, try saying this one I was taught. I'm not, like, claiming to be the best at teaching people to do posh accents. If you say ears, so say ears.
Ears.
Okay.
Ears.
Now just imagine that I've just asked you a question that needed the answer yes, and say ears. So you work for Netflix.
Ears.
Did
that sound like a, that did not sound like a yes.
That's it. Ears. Honestly, they say ears.
Maybe if I say ears. Posher. Ears.
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 So instead of yes, you just say ears.
Ears.
Done it. Sorted. There you go.
I wasn't taught that.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how similar are you actually to your characters and what you learned about them?
Well, Josh always has a boiled egg with every meal.
Neither of us can be that similar, can we? Because we don't live in a
different
big old palace.
Yeah.
We're pretty different.
There's a bit where Diana's out with her mates after the proposal, and they, like, go out and they're dancing. And that day of filming felt incredibly close to what I actually do with my mates. But that was also interesting because it was kind of like, wow, this was her life before it changed.
Yeah.
And that was quite emotional moment of realization.
I don't think I'm anything like Prince Charles, to be honest. The character or the real man. I think I'm quite different.
Beauty of being a great actor, do you know what I mean?
Ears.
Completely different.
You know I mean? Ears are the different. I've got similar ears.
If you could play two other real people from history for your next show or movie, who would you pick?
Patti Smith.
Oh, wow, quick.
Oh, that's good.
Quick would be awesome.
Or Marina Abramovich.
Oh,
yeah.
Or Joan Didion.
Okay, right.
Sorry.
Mine would be David Beckham.
That's really good.
Not because I think I look like him, because I don't. But I just, he's my idol.
Or you could do David Beckham posh spice.
Yeah, that
would be
sick.
Joke.
Yeah, David Beckham probably. That's literally, I'm not very cool. Not very cool.
Let's play a quick game of most likely to, okay?
Oh, fun.
Who is most likely to fall asleep or take a nap on set?
I think that's me, isn't it?
Yeah, did you actually do it?
Not necessarily on set. Like, I'll be I work very hard. But then I'd have like a sleep a day. Actually, it's a real problem for me is that I eat very quickly because I want to maximize my nap time.
Yeah.
So I wolf down my food and then pass out.
Who's most likely to laugh while delivering a line?
If it's past 6 o'clock, definitely.
Oh yeah, if it's
me.
Past 6 o'clock, okay. Emma Corrin, useless to anyone.
Just have this thing where 6 o'clock.
It's like 6 o'clock, and then sometimes she would just have this kind of random spurt of madness, and it might not be 6 o'clock, and we'd just say it's 6 o'clock somewhere.
Who would be most likely to accidentally share a show secret in public?
I think it'd probably me.
Yeah. 100%. No, but again, you're really good.
I think I start talking and then sometimes just...
Yeah, no, you're really good. You don't do that at all. Thanks. But if anyone was going to, out of us two, it might be Emma.
During my research of the two of you, I came across an interview with you, Josh, from last year, in which you said, and I quote, "I've got my eyes on something and I'm going to steal it at the end of series 4. It's a paperweight with Prince Charles's head in it." Did you steal it? I just want to know. I've got really invested. Did you steal it?
I didn't. And it's such a tragedy. Yeah. I'm glad you brought that up, actually. I had plans to steal it.
Yeah, I was invested in this petty theft.
And I've still got plans.
Okay.
The problem is that at the end of series 4, we had to finish like 2 or 3 days early because of COVID.
Yeah.
And went into lockdown. I had a plan ready, which is that I knew roughly where that paperweight was going to be. Mm. Might even still be there now.
That sounds like the paperweight might have had other plans.
I knew where he was going to be at what time.
Paperweight watched the interview and was like, absolutely not.
I'm going to run. No, I had plans to steal him it, and I haven't been able to carry out those plans. Right. But who's to say...
Did you ever
whoever gets
thing?
Cast, well, whoever gets cast as Prince Charles in series 5 and 6, who's to say that I might not reach out to them and say, "Yo, hit me
Please
up."
Please steal it. I wish I'd stolen it for you, and I could have been like, "Well, actually."
Oh, what?
No,
moment.
No. That was, imagine an icebreaker situation where you pretty much have one chance to impress the room, right? What is the fun fact or special talent that either of you share about yourselves?
I was, for a brief time, chairman of the Clifton Hot Air Balloon Appreciation Society.
Really? No, you're lying.
No, I'm not. It's a tragedy.
Do you really like
the
hot
great
air
tragedy
balloons?
Is that I have never been in one. I am a big fan of hot air balloons, but more as a kind of visual concept. I like the shape of them.
Yeah,
I like
fair.
The drama of them. I like the literature that surrounds them, but I've never been in one. And I joined a society when I was living in Bristol like 10 or 11 years ago. And I was asked to guest edit the newsletter. And in the newsletter, I wrote an account of my first trip on a hot air balloon. Mm. But I didn't want to tell everyone that I was actually scared of being in a hot air balloon. So I made it up.
Goodness.
Some of my best writing.
Amazing.
To date.
What's my icebreaker?
What about your car?
My car?
A nice car.
That's the worst icebreaker.
The most interesting thing about me is that I drive a Maserati.
You threw me under the bus there,
Joe.
I got a nice car. I'm outside, check out my wheel.
It's also not even like, it implies that she's got like some unbelievable Ferrari, which maybe you do have.
Maybe you
Who
do.
Knows?
Do you have a Porsche outside?
No, okay.
No, Joshua, I want you
I
to have
royally
a Porsche.
Stitched her up here. This is not what...
You deserve the Maserati, it's fine. Yeah.
Oh my god, I wish you had a Maserati.
Imagine. No, I don't.
Although that is something that I talk about a lot. If I was like awkward silence at a party, I'll be like, I've got a VW Golf. And then people are like, right? Yeah.
No, the best bit is I remember us talking about what like would be your dream car. And I was like, oh, all these things. And Josh was like, Volvo.
I'm a huge Volvo fan. It's such a weird thing to be a fan of.
No, I'm like a fan of Nissans, and like that is
that is niche.
That is really niche.
No, I know that's very.
Maybe cool. We'll both get given a Volvo and a Nissan.
I can't believe you think my icebreaker is my car. I was like, that's really
this
bad.
Says a lot about you. No, I'm joking. I was trying to cover up my hot air balloon.
What topic is it that you could talk about for ages and not get bored?
Cars.
I knew you were going to say, I was waiting for it.
I was waiting for
it.
What happened? Oh, I feel like I can talk about a lot of things for a long time.
But listen, it's a hard question to answer.
It is.
Talk about food a lot.
What would your What would yours be?
See, it's a
do you know what, Josh? I'm here to ask questions.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah,
you got it.